sweet, but I be switching it depending on the week. Crystal old red bottle, them I think I cut my feet. They talking about making industry.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot, I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance, find out my not, my not. For Lexin, I fell out and cut the check, my not, paralyzed the set, but I bet I been taking hits like I can't die like innocent. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead day, I don't see nothing but red, they gather the blankets and milk.
Hey, just so you know, I talked with the Nike rep the other day. They're really pleased with the partnership so far. Even though there have been some struggles on the field, general interest and sales figures have exceeded their expectations. Honestly, we're in a good place.
Yo, this is great.
Hey there, just wanted to see how you're feeling at the halfway point of the season. That rookie wall is coming for you, so you need to be prepared. When you get a chance, either call or text me back and let me know where you think you need the most work, all right? I'm sure your trainers are doing a great job, but a little extra input doesn't hurt, right?
You know, this has always been my worst week of the season, ever since I was a rookie.
How come? Because of the trade deadline?
Yeah, man. Even in my first year, I was on the block. By now, you think this feeling would be something I was used to.
That ain't your fault, though, bro. There's so many bad GMs out there.
Nah, it ain't. But here's the thing. It don't really matter who's at fault. Just like it wasn't my fault when I got rolled up on an injured year, too.
Yeah. Well, at least you know that ain't the case this year.
When I signed here back in March, I hope this be my last stop. Starting to feel like I made the right choice.
I think you did, Carter.
And you know, if you good with the face of the franchise, then no doubt he'll put in a good word for me next year.
Hey, I don't have that kind of clout, man. I ain't LeBron.
Not yet. But where you are, you remember who showed you the ropes.
Yeah. I got you.
I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I just got 20, I'm running on empty. This mobile that came from my money is silly. I feel the envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is, if you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. Yeah, I get the W.
EA Sports brings you a special edition of the National Football League for this Halloween matchup. It's the Bengals and the Jets, and it comes your way next on Madden Football.
From the stadium that hosted Super Bowl 48 back in 2014, there's a look at MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford. A few moments ago, the crowd here was on their feet as their beloved Jets made their way out of the tunnel. They're ready to go. It should be a good one as the two-year Jets get set to face off with the Cincinnati Bengals. Gotten alongside Charles Davis and CD. You look at the Bengals in this matchup, and they know that they are in for a fight here.
And anytime you're dealing with the number one defense in the league, all through your preparation, you know that yards are going to be tough to come by. But working in their favor, they can run the football, one of the top five teams in the league in that category. So I expect this one to be a tight, hard-hitting affair, and both teams playing to their strengths.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Here's the first carry for Le'Veon Bell. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35.
Let's go! Let's go!
A good run there off right tackle in an old-school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
Now Bell. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. Nowhere. It'll be back at the 36. Nowhere. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss.
Let's go.
Back to throw. Cobb. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Eli Apple. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And they are a game under 500 now following the loss a week ago. And this is a team, Charles, that just has not been able to string victories together.
Yeah, they're certainly going the wrong way, aren't they? Because it looked like they had things pointing the right direction, but now they've lost two straight, and that means this game is vital, extremely important, because they fell two games below 500. The road back into playoff contention, awfully difficult.
On first down, Cobb. Room to run past midfield. And he's got it across the 50 to the 47-yard line.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll try the right side with Bell. Bell sheds him off. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete, and he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 22-yard line.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
And he completes it to Berrios. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. Second quarter now from MetLife Stadium. The Jets with the football here. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Bell. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Le'Veon Bell. His ninth touchdown of the season. And the Jets have made this a one-score game. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. From the gun, Cobb. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Going deep here for Landry. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Dancing to his left. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
Carter Landry at this stage of his career, we know he's had some injuries and he's been around a time or two, but definitely still a factor when you need the tough yards on third downs. And he uses those big mitts of his to pull that one in and keep the drive moving.
Up to make the play there defensively, Von Bell, leading tackler in Cincinnati last year. Back to throw now on second and 10. Over the middle, that's the tight end, Landry. And they will get him down, but not before he gets very good yardage there, as that will lead us right into the two-minute warning. Coming up at halftime, we remind you once again that we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL as we reach now, hard to believe, the halfway point of the season. Time flying.
It certainly is. Time to get the sweaters out, my man.
Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Off the play fake. Cobb. This is caught, and they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the two. First down now, but that clock rolling. They'll try and run it in with Bell. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Le'Veon Bell. His 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game. And the Jets are able to make this a close game again. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the second time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack. And you just have to love watching the way he can create.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. On first and 10, Cobb is going to fire one deep over the middle. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I like what they did there because many of the deep throws we see in the course of a game come to the outside, the perimeter of the field. In this case, they used the slot receiver to run deep downfield and tried to connect that way. Unsuccessful in that attempt, but I like what they were doing.
He's going to look deep for more. Room here to run. There he goes, right side. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Elijah Moore, as the first half is winding down. And the Jets have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. We saw this plenty last year in college. He loved to take his shots downfield, and that throw, that was a thing to behold there.
And I'm telling you, nobody would look up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield, and you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
And that one, and even 60 yards in the air, wow. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Off play action, Cobb. Now he'll let it go deep right side. He's got a man, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. It's a big play that time by the Jets.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. They'll give this to Bell running right. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Looking to throw on second down. Cobb caught here by Bell. Bell a first down and then some. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of four. Off the play fake. Cobb. He's going to go up top for the end zone. Back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
This goes to the goal line. You got to be very careful with the offense called rub routes. When I call a pick trying to screen you off from your coverage, does a nice job of avoiding that and helping force an incompletion.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Looking to throw. Cobb. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. 53 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot.
That's funny, partner. Le'Veon Bell, when he came out of Michigan State, when I go back and look at my analysis of him and what my grades were for him, thought he was a big-time player, great potential, but I didn't know we were going to get this player. I was used to a big, solid, thick running back, but now I've got a full package, a guy who can do everything, as we just saw there, including breaking tackles.
But at the time, and that is pulled in by Herndon for a Jets touchdown. Chris Herndon, his first touchdown on the year. And the Jets have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half.
You get down near the goal.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And a bit of a daunting task here for this offense as they'll start out at the 1 yard line.
I guess you could easily say there's a whole lot of real estate in front of them if they want to achieve their goal, which is get to the other end zone.
And 99 yards to go if they want to do just that. And he'll get this up past the 5 to the 7 yard line. It's a 6 yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
But both teams practice this situation. And this time, the guys on offense won, and in a very nice way. What a run from that position on their own goal line.
Gave them some good breathing room.
I wonder now, do you still stack the line of scrimmage, or do you play normal defense? They may have backed them off with that run.
They find some open field here. Bell sheds him off, and he'll be taken down, but they've got this one up to the 35-yard line.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Now a first down carry by Bell. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Let's go, let's go, let's go. is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. It's Jet football as they've got the lead here, and we get set to begin quarter number four. On first down, Bell. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And he is going to be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bengals 42. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up. They'll try and run for it with Bell. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. 118 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw.
And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. From the shotgun, it's a give to Bell. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And able to connect with Berrios. And he is going to have a Jets first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that pickup on the first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
They'll run on first down. It's Bell. And he's brought down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. 57. Now Bell, and he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Le'Veon Bell, fine work there on the touchdown run. And the Jets look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. So they brought the extra bulk in down on the 1 yard line. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now defensively, they do have all 3 timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. They'll try and run some clock now with Bell. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Now following the interception, this offense will get another shot at it as they'll quickly head back onto the field. They'll go again with Bell. And he's got Rome. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout as it'll come with an even 90 seconds remaining on the clock. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And we'll see if the defense wants to stop it as they take the knee. Jets with victory seemingly in hand, they take the knee. Defense, they'll spread the field, a dime package here on 3rd and 12. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it. So it's a victory here for the New York Jets. That was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for the Jets, they're into the win column for the third time this year as they get the victory here. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Indianapolis Colts. Meanwhile, for Cincinnati, they'll fall to 5-3 with a loss. And they'll try to make amends next week as they host the Cleveland Browns.